Well, cast your mind back to February last year, and you may remember the excitement when NASA successfully landed its Perseverance rover on Mars. Well, it's been busy for the last 15 months or so, doing plenty of roving, and now it's ready for the most important part of the mission, searching for signs of life.
For years, Mars has called out to us with its strange red glow, pushing us to send mission after mission, desperately seeking answers. The Viking missions in the 1970s dug into Martian soil, desperately searching for signs of life, only to come up empty-handed. But what if these missions have uncovered something so profound, so unsettling, that it could change our future forever? Join us as we delve into this latest shocking discovery by NASA's Mars rover and unravel the truth that may reshape our understanding of the universe. Exposing the mysteries of Mars. But what exactly are we dealing with here? What have these rovers really uncovered since they first touched down on the red planet? Our fascination with Mars isn't new. It's a story that dates back centuries, earning Mars the ominous nickname, the Red Planet. But it wasn't until the dawn of the space age that we truly began to explore its enigmatic surface. NASA's groundbreaking Mariner 4 mission in 1964 was our first successful attempt, flying by Mars and sending back haunting images of a desolate, cratered world. This was just the beginning, a revelation that left us hungry for more, pushing us to probe deeper, to question more. And now, with this latest discovery, we're forced to confront a chilling possibility. What if Mars has been hiding a deadly secret all along? Over the following decades, many more missions were launched. The Viking missions in the 1970s were particularly important. Viking 1 and Viking 2 both landed on Mars and conducted experiments to look for signs of life. While they didn't find anything definitive, they gathered a lot of information about the Martian soil, atmosphere, and climate. Since then, exploration of Mars has advanced significantly, with each mission building on the success of the last. In the 1990s, the Mars Pathfinder mission included a small rover called Sojourner, a six-wheeled robot that moved around, studying rocks and soil. This was a big leap forward, proving that we could not only land on Mars, but also explore its surface. The 2000s brought even more ambitious missions. The Mars Global Surveyor orbited the planet, mapping it in great detail, while the Mars Odyssey mission, launched in 2001, discovered large amounts of hydrogen beneath the surface, suggesting the presence of underground water ice. The journey started with the Sojourner rover from the Mars Pathfinder mission and continued with the twin rovers, Spirit and Opportunity, which landed in 2004. These rovers were expected to operate for just 90 days, but they far exceeded those expectations, exploring for years. Spirit examined the Gusev crater, while Opportunity made incredible discoveries from other parts of Mars. In the region called Meridiani Planum, scientists found evidence that water once flowed there. This discovery inspired NASA to take on a new mission, to build the most advanced rovers yet, designed to explore Mars more thoroughly and answer more difficult questions. The landing itself was incredibly tense and complicated, known as the 7 minutes of terror. It included a sky crane maneuver that had never been tried before. Despite the risk, the landing went perfectly, and Curiosity immediately started sending images from the Martian surface, marking a new chapter in Mars exploration. Curiosity is packed with advanced tools to help in its mission. It's about the size of a car, measuring 10 feet long, 9 feet wide, and 7 feet tall, and it weighs nearly 2,000 pounds. One of its standout features is the ChemCam, which can zap rocks and soil with a laser to turn them into gas for analysis. It's like a laser gun that helps scientists figure out what the materials on Mars are made of. Another remarkable tool is the Sample Analysis at Mars, or SAM. This mini lab analyzes the chemical makeup of Martian samples to look for organic compounds, which are crucial for determining if the planet could support life. Curiosity is powered by a radioisotope thermoelectric generator, RTG, which converts the heat from decaying plutonium-238 into electricity. This power source allows Curiosity to keep working day and night through all Martian seasons. Let's explore how a sixth grader named a rover that's now revealing Mars' secrets. Mars, $2.5 billion. But all this technology didn't come cheap. The entire Mars Science Laboratory mission, including Curiosity, cost around $2.5 billion. However, the mission has provided priceless information about Mars, making the investment worthwhile many times over. The name Curiosity has an interesting story behind it. In 2009, NASA held a contest for students across the United States to name the new rover. Clara Ma, a sixth grader from Kansas, won the contest by suggesting the name Curiosity. In her essay, she described Curiosity as an everlasting flame that drives us to discover and explore, a fundamental trait that pushes humans to new horizons. NASA chose her submission because it perfectly captured the spirit of exploration, reminding us that the desire to learn is something we all share. With its cutting-edge tools and significant funding, what has Curiosity found on Mars? The rover has made some amazing discoveries, greatly expanding our understanding of the Red Planet. For instance, Curiosity has detected organic molecules in rock samples from Gale Crater. These carbon-containing molecules could be the basic building blocks and nutrients for life. But this wasn't the most surprising find. Curiosity's discoveries have only deepened the mystery of Mars and what it might hold for the future. Why is this discovery on Mars so important? Finding organic compounds on Mars hints at the possibility that the planet might have supported life forms in the past. Scientists studying the carbon dioxide and methane isotopes found that these could either be leftovers from ancient life or just the result of natural chemical reactions involving sunlight in Mars's atmosphere. This finding has huge implications and has led to ongoing research, not just by the Curiosity rover, but also by future missions focused on exploring life in the universe. Curiosity's research showed inconsistent methane levels in the Martian atmosphere. On Earth, this usually points to biological activity, but it's still unclear if this is true for Mars. While Curiosity can't confirm the exact source, it does suggest that biological processes might be happening on the Red Planet. Another key part of Curiosity's mission is to figure out the age and origins of Martian rocks. The rocks around Gale Crater, which are thought to have formed about 4 billion years ago, ended up in Yellowknife Bay and turned into sedimentary rocks. About 70 million years ago, natural erosion exposed these rocks, giving scientists a chance to study how Mars has eroded over time and how radiation has affected organic materials that might help us find signs of past life. But this isn't the most exciting part. Curiosity's exploration also suggests that Mars once had a rich, watery history, which is crucial for life. The discovery of jarosite, a mineral that only forms in wet conditions, indicates that Mars had significant bodies of water. Studies of jarosite have shown that water might have been present beneath Mars' surface for much longer than previously thought, meaning that habitable conditions might have lasted longer than we believed. Curiosity has also given us insights into how Mars lost its atmosphere, transforming it from a place that might have supported life to the dry, barren landscape we see today. By measuring the hydrogen isotopes in water, Curiosity has provided clues about how Mars lost its water and how its climate has changed, helping us better understand the planet's environmental shifts. Next, we find out why Mars might have once been home to life, the search for ancient life on Mars. But this wasn't the last surprise. Curiosity also discovered nitrogen, a vital element for life as we know it, in a form that living organisms can use. This suggests that the conditions needed to support life might have existed on Mars billions of years ago, highlighting the planet's potential for having been habitable in the past. These discoveries are why NASA decided to extend Curiosity's mission until at least 2025. However, to fully understand Mars, we need more than just one rover. That's why NASA launched the Perseverance rover in 2020. Perseverance landed at Jezero Crater in 2021, a place that was likely an ancient river delta and lake, making it a perfect spot to search for signs of past life. The landing of Perseverance was nerve-wracking, involving a high-speed atmospheric entry and precise landing maneuvers, since there was a communication delay between Mars and Earth. But this successful landing means Perseverance can now continue the work that Curiosity started, furthering our quest to understand Mars' history and whether it could have hosted life. One of these tools is the Mars Oxygen In-Situ Resource Utilization Experiment, or MOXIE. I'll explain more about what MOXIE does shortly, but first, let's talk about the rover's cameras and sensors. Perseverance has 19 cameras, setting a new record for the most cameras ever sent to Mars. These cameras capture clear images and videos of the Martian landscape, helping scientists back on Earth to study the planet's geology and search for signs of past life. Additionally, Perseverance is equipped with a drill to collect rock and soil samples. These samples are sealed in containers, possibly to be brought back to Earth in the future. The rover's wheels have also been redesigned to make them more durable and give them better grip, which is crucial for driving across Mars' rough terrain. Like its predecessor, Perseverance is powered by a radioisotope thermoelectric generator. This generator uses the heat from the decay of plutonium-238 to produce electricity, allowing the rover to operate throughout the year. But the story behind how Perseverance got its name is quite fascinating. In 2019, NASA asked students to suggest a name for the rover and explain their choice in an essay contest. A seventh grader named Alexander Mather submitted the winning name, Perseverance. He believed that the human spirit, which has always overcome challenges, was a perfect symbol for this important space mission. NASA agreed, thinking the name captured the mission's essence, and so they officially named the rover Perseverance, or Percy for short. Now, one of the most exciting parts of Perseverance's mission is its small companion, the Ingenuity helicopter. You might wonder, why include a helicopter when the rover already has 19 cameras? The reason lies in what Ingenuity adds to the mission. Ingenuity arrived on Mars on February 18, 2021, attached beneath Perseverance. This small helicopter was initially supposed to complete just 5 flights over 30 Martian days to prove that controlled flight was possible in Mars's thin atmosphere. Each flight lasted up to 90 seconds and reached heights between 10 to 16 feet. But this wasn't the most remarkable part. Ingenuity far exceeded expectations. After its successful test flights, NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory began planning more flights to see how Ingenuity could help with exploring Mars. It started scouting for interesting areas for Perseverance to explore, improving navigation methods, and testing the limits of what it could achieve in flight. This aerial view gave scientists important information that the rover alone couldn't easily gather, such as identifying the best routes and uncovering intriguing geological features. Now let's see how a small helicopter is changing the way we explore Mars. The remarkable path of Ingenuity. The technology behind Ingenuity is impressive. It weighs only 4 pounds and has blades that spin at around 2,400 revolutions per minute, much faster than helicopters on Earth, which is necessary due to the thin Martian atmosphere. This innovation marks a big step forward in our ability to explore other planets, especially Mars, and hints at what future planetary exploration could look like. Ingenuity, the small helicopter on Mars, can recharge its batteries using solar panels, allowing it to operate independently. It has a navigation camera and a communication system to send information to the Perseverance rover, which then relays it back to Earth. Over nearly 3 years, Ingenuity performed better than expected, completing 72 flights. In total, it flew for 2 hours, 8 minutes, and 48 seconds across 1,004 Martian days, covering over 17 kilometers. This showed how reliable it is and how useful flying robots can be for exploring other planets. But everything changed on January 18, 2024, during its 72nd flight. Ingenuity's rotor blades were damaged when it landed, which meant the helicopter could no longer fly. NASA declared the mission over a week later. However, despite this setback, Ingenuity and Perseverance made many important discoveries together. When scientists chose Jezero Crater for Perseverance's landing, they had different ideas about the kinds of rocks they might find. Some thought the rocks were ancient lava flows, while others believed they were sedimentary rocks shaped by wind or water. In its first year, Perseverance found a variety of igneous rocks, including those formed from slowly cooling magma and lava flows. These rocks contained gem crystals that gave clues about how they formed and interacted with water, hinting that Mars might have had conditions suitable for microbial life in the past. If these samples are brought back to Earth, they could help us learn more about Mars's volcanic history and the age of its geological features in Jezero Crater. But that wasn't the end of the discoveries. On February 16, 2022, Perseverance captured a detailed panoramic view of an area called Santa Cruz using 24 images. This allowed scientists to get a closer look at the boulders and terrain in Jezero Crater. At a place named Wildcat Ridge, within a sedimentary deposit, the rover found evidence of an ancient lake, suggesting that these sediments were deposited in standing water and continued to interact with water even after they were laid down. These environments preserved in the rocks would have been favorable for ancient microbial life and are ideal for preserving potential signs of that life. The studies also showed that Jezero Crater's water history was more complex than scientists had thought. While they knew that a lake once filled the crater, new images revealed that sediments were laid down in a delta, indicating a rich aquatic history. Moreover, there was evidence of intense floods that carried large boulders into the crater, although their origins are still a mystery. But the geological discoveries weren't the only breakthroughs. Perseverance also achieved a technological milestone with the MOXIE experiment, which successfully produced oxygen from Mars' carbon dioxide-rich atmosphere. Over 16 operations, MOXIE generated about 4 ounces, 122 grams of oxygen, enough to keep an astronaut alive for around 4 hours. This proved that making oxygen on Mars is possible. Finally, we hear Mars itself and learn what Perseverance has been up to, the Martian soundscape revealed. By September 2023, after 2 years of operation, MOXIE completed its final task. Another fascinating achievement was recording the sounds of Mars. For the first time, scientists could hear the Martian environment through microphones on Perseverance, capturing sounds like the Martian wind and the noise from its dust removal tool. These recordings confirm that sound travels more slowly on Mars, giving new insights into the planet's atmosphere. On Mars, where the air is mostly carbon dioxide and much thinner than Earth's, sounds behave quite differently. The way sound travels changes with the seasons on Mars, as the air pressure shifts. During times when the pressure is low, the microphone on the Mars rover picks up almost nothing, resulting in near silence, a big contrast to Earth, where we hear sounds more easily. On Mars, sounds become quieter and more muffled, and high-pitched noises like whistles are especially hard to hear. This study of sound on Mars gives us new clues about how the planet's atmosphere changes with the seasons and helps us understand how well the rover is functioning. It's important to note that these discoveries weren't made by the Perseverance rover alone. The helicopter Ingenuity also played a key role. Together, these two machines have sent back some amazing data, including the latest video footage. For example, the Curiosity rover was the first to capture a full 360-degree video on Mars, and now Perseverance has delivered a stunning panoramic view from where Ingenuity last landed, all in sharp 4K quality. These images give us an incredible look at the Martian landscape. While these rovers are busy gathering data, NASA is already thinking about the future of Mars exploration. Right now, the rovers are collecting samples that scientists hope will tell us more about Mars's ancient past and whether it could have ever supported life. However, these samples won't make it back to Earth until at least 2033. That's because they will be brought back by the Mars Sample Return Program, a complex NASA mission designed to safely bring these samples home. The plan involves a lander on Mars retrieving the samples, which are then sent into orbit around Mars. There, an orbiter will pick them up and bring them back to Earth. This mission is crucial because it will allow scientists to study the Martian material using the advanced tools we have on our planet. While the samples make their long journey to Earth, the rovers will stay on Mars. Curiosity, which has already given us valuable information about whether Mars could have supported life, will keep exploring alongside Perseverance. Both will continue their important work on the Martian surface. Collecting samples is just one part of NASA's bigger plan, which might eventually lead to humans living on Mars. Musk is also looking into ways to create sustainable living conditions on Mars, using the planet's natural resources to produce essentials like water and oxygen. The goal is to build a place on Mars where humans can live without relying on supplies from Earth. NASA and SpaceX are working together on several projects to develop the technology and plans needed for human missions to Mars. These efforts are pushing forward our exploration of the Red Planet and laying the groundwork for eventually making Mars a place where people can live. Both organizations are committed to developing the tools and infrastructure necessary to support long-term human habitation on Mars. What are your thoughts on colonizing Mars? Is it an exciting new frontier or a dangerous distraction? Like, comment, and subscribe for more.